Channel tonight.
We welcome you here to Bowling Green, Kentucky, on the campus of Western Kentucky University. A rainy night, but we've got a great basketball game upcoming between the Hilltoppers of Western Kentucky and the Monarchs of Old Dominion. As we take a look at the standings in Conference USA, Middle Tennessee leading the way at 14-1. But close behind, Old Dominion and Western Kentucky, both at 13-2. And hi, everybody, along with Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Twibel. It is great to be with you. We've got another terrific Conference USA game coming your way tonight. And it is senior night here at Western Kentucky. Tim, we're going to talk about Dwight Colby. We're going to talk about Justin Johnson and Darius Thompson.
All three of those guys have been significant, and they all have different skill sets. Darius Thompson, a big guard transfer from UVA, comes in, and he does a lot of things because of his size advantage. Very skilled individual. And then Dwight Colby plays on the rim at both ends. He's a shot blocker and rim protector, but man, when they throw it inside, he is dynamite. And finally, the four-year senior, Justin Johnson. He's been doing it the same way since the day he walked through the doors. He delivers at the bucket. He can step out and knock down threes. And again, this big three has been great for Coach Rick Stansbury. You look at the numbers, all of them over 12 points, 14.6, 14.9. They shoot good percentages, and they bring other things. Dwight Colby shot blocking and rebounding. Justin Johnson, a little bit of everything. And Darius Thompson is the straw that stirs the drink.
You better believe it. Meanwhile, for Old Dominion, a good win Thursday night at Marshall. We were at that game, and we saw a rebounding display by Brandon Stith. 21 points, 12 rebounds, and Tim, 9 on the offensive board.
Yeah, and, you know, we talked to Jeff Jones about Brandon Stith, the young son of Bryant, the assistant. You look at him clean up around the bucket. He can get up and jump with the best of them in this conference. He attacks the glass, and if you don't box out, Brandon Stith is going to hurt you tonight. Shot blockers, beware, because when you go to block that shot, Brandon Stith is lurking.
Old Dominion's been on a roll. They've won 6 in a row, 10 of their last 11, and 17 of their last 19. But in the previous meeting this year, Western Kentucky came away with a 75-68 victory. It's Old Dominion and Western Kentucky coming up next.
Head coach Rick Stansbury.
And welcome to Diddle Arena as we get set for this Conference USA matchup between Old Dominion and Western Kentucky. Senior night. Starting lineups. Tim, as we take a look at Old Dominion, they've had the same starting lineup all year long.
And they have been spectacular, too. Ahmad Kaver, in particular, the guard that handles the ball well, although he turned it over a lot the other night. But BJ and Brandon Stith, big-time players. Randy Haynes has been very aggressive, and Trey Porter needs to stay out of foul trouble.
Meanwhile, for Western Kentucky, 4 games ago, Lamonte Burton was put at the point guard spot. They've been terrific ever since.
It really helped them, and you know, Coach Stansbury had that in his mind to do. They're doing it late in the year, and it's really helped them.
Jeff Jones, the head coach for Old Dominion, 5th year for the Monarchs, with Jones as the head coach. Longtime coach, of course, at Virginia and American, and then Rick Stansbury in his 2nd year. And what a turnaround, a losing record last year. They were picked to finish 6th in the preseason poll. They are 13-2 in conference, tied for 2nd place.
And they don't have a lot of guys in uniform. You look at their bench, there's only 3 guys, maybe 4 over there that could possibly play, and he doesn't even use all of them. They're not deep, but this starting 5 is as good as anybody in this conference.
Oh.
Take 2.
There we go. We're underway. Great crowd here tonight. There's Bearden, number 1, looking for Johnson inside. Thompson's 15.
No double. Let's see what happens.
Turn around. Got it.
That's a tough matchup for Brandon Stith. He's a good defender, but he's going to need some help with Justin Johnson, especially here on senior night. He's jacked.
Kaver, number 4, guarded by Hollingsworth, the freshman. Great job there by Hollingsworth, taking it away from B.J. Stith.
And that's a beautiful double team. It wasn't quite in the post, but they worked on that great in practice in the shoot-around today, already cashing it in.
Hollinsworth, one of the top freshmen in the conference. Bearden will run the show off the pick by Colby. Johnson turns it down from three. Step back pop. Hits! I think he's got it going.
Already.
Yeah.
You can tell. And he's been waiting for this night for a long time for a lot of reasons.
Yeah.
And right now, he's got this crowd ignited.
Haynes, he loses it.
Here we go.
Down to Bearden. And in. That's a quick 6-0 start for Western Kentucky. Caver trying to get things settled down right now for the Monarchs.
Already you see two turnovers leading to buckets. Jeff Jones' team doesn't turn it over that much, about 10.3 a game.
Haynes loses it. Looked like Bearden got it. Hollinsworth loses it. That's going to be a double dribble.
He knew it, too. He didn't. He couldn't be the next person to touch it, but he had to pick it up because that would have been a run out the other way.
How about this defensive intensity by the Hilltoppers?
Yeah, and Old Dominion is known for their defense, but right now they're having trouble with the disruptive play of the Hilltoppers. They are spending energy, they are getting to their spots, and they really causing problems.
Caver's got to get things organized for Old Dominion. There's a great matchup with Johnson on Stith out top.
Also, Colby and Porter in the post.
Yes.
At both ends, that's going to be fun.
Haynes for three, tough. Won't go. Offensive rebound. Boy, guess who? Offensive
Brandon.
Rebounding machine, you better believe it. Caver step back and he hits it. That's a three. Tough shot right there.
It is, but we watch him and Randy Haynes do that. They just create what look like tough shots, but they're able to knock them down. That's what's impressive about Old Dominion, especially late. They can get great shots late in possessions.
Darius Thompson inside to Colby. And he's fouled.
Let's see if that's on Trey Porter. Coach Jones doesn't have a lot in terms of size once Porter goes out.
Foul was on Stith. Brandon Stith.
Stith either, though. They don't play a lot of it. We talked about the lack of depth from Western, but Old Dominion doesn't go very deep in theirs either.
And Colby hits the first one. 73% at the free throw line. Colby, who spent the last 2 years at Kansas, transferred from Ole Miss to Kansas, tore his ACL in his redshirt year, just was slow to recover from that, never really got a chance at KU, but man, has he made the most of this opportunity at Western Kentucky.
He certainly found a home, and he is as good as anybody in the post in this conference, and that includes Nick King from Middle Tennessee.
Step back three by Caver, that's short, and Johnson comes up with a loose ball. Darius Thompson, Johnson for three, hits! That's what's called a zone right there. He's in the zone.
That was a shot to the goal from Justin Johnson.
11-3. Western Kentucky with the lead. A double team on Porter. Now Stith will turn around and take the shot. Way short. And Johnson the rebound. Here comes Thompson. Oh, a deep three there. Colby the offensive board. And in it counted.
One thing that was concerning for Jeff Jones is matching the energy of Western on senior night. So far, they have been outplayed. Look at this man's rebound. Goes up with two hands in traffic. Silly foul. Conversion.
And the three. Three-point play. B.J. Stith committed the foul. So and it's 14-3, Tim.
This is the kind of start you can't afford on the road if you're Jeff Jones and Old Dominion.
Sweet move there by Haynes, the up and under.
That's what I'm talking about. Randy Haynes has been aggressive.
Hollinsworth for three. And Caver skies for the rebound.
And Old Dominion, they're poised now. They're not going to wilt under this pressure. But they maybe that Haynes shot got them regrouped.
And traveling.
Or maybe not.
Yeah. senior night here in Western Kentucky, and what a start for the Hilltoppers. Justin Johnson, they lead it 14-5. Welcome back. Along with Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Twybaugh. The Hilltoppers off to a great start. They lead ODU 14-5. Senior night, and Tim a little bit more as Justin Johnson.
Yeah, he was jacked, as you can see, for obvious reasons. But what people didn't know is that before the game, he proposed to his fiance now.
Keely Rogers.
Put a ring on it, and he liked it, so he put a ring on it. But this was a reason why he's smiling from ear to ear. And but boy, did he get a great start, as you see her
with her family members up in the stands. And what a moment. And what a start by Justin Johnson.
Yeah.
7 points already.
Euphoria, man. I mean, this kid is obviously overjoyed at what the thought of marrying his fiance. But man, is he jacked for this game as well. That trail three, we knew it was in the second and left his hands. He's locked in.
Darius Thompson. Johnson looking inside to Colby, and why not? There's a deep three. Again! How about that? Huh?
If I was Dick Vitale, I'd be saying, are you serious?
Well, go ahead.
Are you serious?
You can say that. All right. 17-5. Porter. Oh!
Whoa.
That's what happens. You get a little bit rattled. Guys start trying to do a little too much.
But even the simple things start to become difficult because you start pressing. But again, I think Jeff Jones's team is resilient in terms of mental toughness. Let's see if they can weather this storm. But the way Justin Johnson's playing, it could be a long night.
Hollingsworth finds Johnson. He goes inside to Colby.
Got a double here. Good defense.
And the rebound. Great job right there by Trey Porter.
And a nice dive down by Ahmed Caver to force him baseline. Tough shot.
Block.
Oh, man.
Darius Thompson, and it's going to be Western Kentucky basketball. Woo! Great block there by Darius Thompson as B.J. Stiff went up for the jump shot.
A couple of UVA transfers, one for each team right there, going at it. And Thompson gets the better of the younger Stiff. BJ.
Josh Anderson, 6'6 freshman from Baton Rouge, checks into the game for Western Kentucky. And Aaron Carver, 6'7 sophomore from Elizabeth City, North Carolina, now in for Old Dominion.
Let's see if Carver can handle Johnson. Here comes the double again. Great hands. Oh, he
fouled.
Wow, they're going to say that was two shots, too.
How about this career? Total points, 16th. Field goal percentage, 8th. Total rebounds, 6th. Double-double, 6th.
Not many people in America have gotten 1,500 points and 1,000 rebounds in a career, and Justin's going to do it.
In the first meeting, Tim, this year between these two teams, Justin Johnson, 25 points and 14 rebounds. He is on pace maybe to duplicate that tonight.
He's well on his way, man. And when he's playing like that, Western Kentucky is as good as anybody in this conference.
19-5. Hilltoppers with the lead. Great pressure defense. That's Anderson. And he's going to be called for the foul. Anderson just became eligible right after the first of the year.
Good, solid freshman coming off the bench. He's got great upside. Very athletic. Gets this crowd into it at times. He's going to be one of those guys for the next 4 years that people will be excited about
absolutely.
In Bowling Green.
Oh, such good defense by Western Kentucky right now. 8 on the shot clock. Caver, tough shot there. Hits it. That's two tough threes that he's knocked down.
I mean, Hollingsworth played that as well. He knew he was going to do the step back. He knows the scouting report. And he probably did follow him on the arm a little bit, but no matter. Ahmad Caver, big shot.
And he's got 5 of their 8 points.
But you can't live by him creating shots like that, possession by possession. They got to find some easy ones.
Anderson the miss. Haynes bringing it down court for the Monarchs.
to the glass. Can't get it to go. Johnson tips it outside. And then Thompson found it to Colby. And the finish by Darius Thompson.
Very poor decision by B.J. Stith to go for that ball. Once he missed it, it's a 3-0.
21-8. And that was just a matter of keeping the basketball alive by Western Kentucky.
Exactly. Justin Johnson started that thing.
Haynes in and out for three, and Johnson the rebound.
With the energy and the electricity in this building, I think a lot of the Power Fives would have trouble coming in here right now.
Thompson off the glass. Loose ball. Haynes comes away with it for Old Dominion. They've got the numbers 3-on-2. Stiff. Back out to Caver. DJ Stith in the corner won't go, and Johnson the rebound. We approach the 12:30 mark here in the first half in Western Kentucky with a 21-8 lead over Old Dominion.
So now they're going to be a little patient, get what they want if they can. Old Dominion's still pretty disruptive with that defensive end when they're locked in.
Johnson again. He's got 14.
Justin Johnson is cash money right now. 5 for 5 from the field, 2 for 2 from downtown. He should get engaged every night.
And B.J. Stith from the corner. That's a 2. That'd be a lot of rings.
I need more rings than Bill Russell, right?
Darius Thompson, Johnson.
We need a Johnson heat check right now, right? See if they can get something late here.
Let's get Colby coming out. What a tough battle. Corner to Hollingsworth. Hits it! Darius Thompson found a way to find the open man.
They are on a roll right now. And Old Dominion looks overwhelmed.
Carver gets it. Now to Haynes. Haynes had a good three-point shooting night against Marshall on Thursday. Can't get that one to go. And Colby the rebound. And here comes Thompson.
There's no offense being run at the Old Dominion end, though.
Johnson! And he's fouled. Welcome back, Western Kentucky, 26-9 over Old Dominion. They took a point away from the Monarchs. They said Caver's 3 really wasn't a 3, but a 2. Of course, it's senior night, and what emotion in this building. There's Dwight Colby, his family from Nassau, Bahamas, and Darius Thompson. Great year that he's had. And then Justin Johnson from Hazard, Kentucky. And how about the proposal difference, Tim?
That's interesting. Yeah. 14 points versus Old Dominion's 9. He's beating them by himself right now, cashing in 5 for 5 from the field. He's already got 4 rebounds as well. And he cannot miss. And you just really don't know how a team is going to react on senior night. You know it's going to be emotional. You know it's going to be a lot of energy. But sometimes teams have trouble harnessing that energy in a positive way. Western has been nothing but positive here in the first part of this game.
So 1 of 2 for Johnson, who does so many things well, but only a 53% free throw shooter. But that's not going to affect this night, as he's already got 15 with 10:30 left to go in the first half. A little runner in the lane won't go. Thompson chasing it down. Looked like it hit off the official.
It did.
And
but the official's part
of the court. Open it in.
Jeff Jones won't be happy with that transition defense. You rarely see them give that up. But right now, they have simply lost their composure.
They trail by 20 as we reach the 10-minute mark here in the first half.
And there's just not a lot of flow to the offense at all right now. Western has been disruptive.
It's just so much pressure. It's relentless. Their defense so far tonight is Caver with the runner and in. It's been all Caver.
He's been the only one, but really him and Randy Haynes are certainly capable of creating shots, but they've been creating tough shots. It's not going to get it done tonight the way Western's playing.
Anderson. Hollingsworth looking into Colby.
Both these teams are very deliberate in terms of trying to get the ball on the inside.
Five on the shot clock. And Hollingsworth knocked to the floor. Shot won't go. And here comes the Monarchs. Ahmad Caver, a junior out of Atlanta, averaging over 14 points and 6.2 assists a contest. BJ Stith hits it. That's a three. They needed that.
They really did. And you know, the anatomy of any comeback, though, is defensive stops and turning up pressure and creating offense off of your defense. That's what Old Dominion is going to have to do to get back in this game, and they are capable.
Thompson sends it back out to Justin Johnson. Can't get that one to go. And Brandon Stith with a rebound as Caver brings it down now for Old Dominion.
Are we all shocked that he missed that shot?
Yes. BJ Stith.
Watch out.
Oh, that's goal. That's goaltending. Wow, what a quick first step that was, huh?
Yeah, explosive. Right now, BJ Stith being a little assertive. You know, he wasn't very aggressive the other night versus Marshall. But here he is off the dribble, going to the hole. And Anderson grabbed the rim. Easy call for this officiating crew.
Couple of subs now for Western Kentucky. Jake Omer, 21, checks into the game. Mark Nelson, number 14, a couple of freshmen. And also back into the game, Monte Burke. Old Dominion on a 7-0 run now as they trail at 29-16. There's Nelson, number 14, Thompson. Bearden, the runner, and in.
It's all going right for Western Kentucky right now.
Goes Caver. Looked like he had an opening, but great help defense right there by Western Kentucky. Green, who's checked into the game now, to pull up. In and out. The tip won't go by Brandon Stiff.
Wow, point blank range, yes. Right there. Missed the opportunity.
Omer thought about it from deep, huh?
He thought better of it.
Yeah, wise young man. You could hear Rick Stansbury from the bench. Thompson, that's an air ball from three.
This is where Old Dominion's got to try to find some easy ones in transition if they can.
Caver for three and knocks it down.
Secondary break works too. Right there, Caver just created that shot again on his own. And again, he's complaining about being fouled. But you look at this, Old Dominion starting to swing things in their direction. There's a ton of possessions left in this game. No need to panic.
Inside, Nelson, great look from Bearden.
But you have to tighten it up at the defensive end. They have let Western Kentucky do whatever they wanted. Now, Johnson hitting all those shots kind of got it going. But now everyone's getting into the act.
That's Xavier Green, number 10. Caver, step back three. Won't go. Thompson the rebound.
Good ball handling right there. It was a couple of guys trying to knock that away from him behind.
Bearden for three. Colby battling.
It's going to be on Colby.
So Dwight Colby had an ACL surgery back in Kansas a couple years ago. Hurt that knee just a little bit. You can see him walking off the court. Doesn't seem to be affecting him that much so far, but that play right there might have got his attention. Welcome back. Western Kentucky with a 33-19 lead over Old Dominion. Along with Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Twidwell. As it has been all Hilltoppers so far. Rick Stansbury, their second-year coach. And how about the last four games? Now, this is in this period of time where they moved Bearden to the point because Thompson had not been in double figures the three previous games. And look at those results, Tim.
And those numbers say it all. But, you know, the 55% in each of the last four games are better. It's because of the offensive efficiency. They're getting great shots because of that move primarily. And give credit to Coach Rick Stansbury.
Caver open, but wow, Bearden came out of nowhere to block it.
Man, that's unbelievable. They just can't get a good look here for the most part. Look at the points in the paint there. Heavily favoring Western.
Thompson, swing it to Omer. Johnson now. Brandon Stith guarding him. That's a heck of a matchup for three. That won't go.
Nice Porter play.
Misses the easy one and cleaning things up, Randy Haynes.
Well, that was a great pass by Caver, and Porter showed himself, made himself available, and got that ball point blank. Didn't convert, but Jeff Jones likes what he sees.
33-21 with 5:20 left to go first half. It's been all Western Kentucky. Nelson trying to set the screen there for Omer.
Got blasted too.
And Bearden is fouled by Haynes. Neither of these teams foul that much.
No, yeah. Especially Old Dominion, one of the least fouling teams in the nation.
Jeff Jones, a terrific player in his own right at Virginia.
He sure was, and I doubt any of his players even know or care about that.
Well, originally from Owensboro, Kentucky, not too far from here.
Yep, played with Ralph Sampson. I'm sure his players know that guy.
How about that? My goodness!
There was a whole lot of creativity on this play right here. Show the fake. He thought he was going to pass it. He keeps it, and then the dexterity around the bucket, somehow able to get that up on the rim. And then, great play by Bearden.
And the 83% free throw shooter not able to complete the three-point play. So as we approach the five-minute mark here in the first half, Western Kentucky with a 14-point lead, 35-21.
If you're Old Dominion, your goal is to get this thing under 10 going into halftime.
Yeah, great look inside by Caver that time to Brandon Steele. Omer, and that's goaltending. What great job by Western Kentucky to move the ball down the court that time.
Yeah. But there was a lack of matchups right there. And, you know, this crowd noise, we talk about that in football all the time. It disrupts offenses. Sometimes it can disrupt basketball teams as well. The lack of communication, no matchups, Western takes advantage.
Whistle away from the ball.
Take a look at Caver as he throws it in the post to Stith. Nobody should be dunking from where he caught that ball. But he turns around and glides to the rim with two hands. Easy.
Foul was on Nelson as Colby checks back into the game for Western Kentucky. Green and Caver, the Stith brothers, and Porter for Old Dominion.
Looking for matchup zone here.
Caver sends it back on top to Green. Five on the shot clock. B.J. Stith. And Bearden the rebound.
And it's one and done for the most part here in the first half. Western is not allowing the buffet on the boards that we saw the other night, particularly from Brandon Stith.
Omer for three. Got it! Jake Omer, the freshman from Taylor Mill, Kentucky. Gives the Hilltoppers a 17-point lead with 3:50 left to go first half.
Omer has been knocking down shots of late. He's gotten his three-point shot up to about 32%.
It's only Division I scholarship offer, Western Kentucky. Caver in the lane, can't get it to go. Battle underneath, and guess what? Brandon Stith.
That's what they need more of for Old Dominion. Go and clean up that bucket, and now the 1-3-1 being deployed by Old Dominion, trying to mix things up. The man-to-man has been ineffective, to say the least. 40 points already.
Inside, Colby trying to get it for the lob.
Great recovery by Ahmad Caver without fouling.
Porter working on Justin Johnson. Size advantage right there, and count it.
I'll count that bucket.
So the 6'10 Porter working on the 6'7 Justin Johnson. How do you like those kicks here at the staff? What do you think of them?
They are bright.
J. Just over 3 minutes left to go in the first half. Western Kentucky leads it by 13. Their biggest lead has been 20. And, Tim, for the third straight game, they've scored 40 in the first half of the game.
And we talked about their offensive efficiency. But the tough defense right now that we usually see from Old Dominion, we're just not seeing it. Points allowed, 62 points a game. They've already given up 40 here with 3 minutes to play. You look at the two guys carrying the load offensively, their top two scorers, the backcourt, B.J. Stith and Amaya Caver, but they're going to need some help from some others.
Porter at the free throw line, and he completes the three-point play. 12-point lead for Western Kentucky.
Here comes the 1-3-1 once again. They got the lob at the rim that they disrupted, but that's the mismatch. If you look, Caver's got to recover back to the basket as the opposite wing. They know. So that's why that lob wasn't by accident. They got the mismatch, but they couldn't cash it in.
Western Kentucky with all their starters back in for the final 250.
Right there. See, Caver's got a tough matchup at the back of that zone when the ball's on the opposite side.
Hollinsworth turned down the three, and then he got fouled. Boy, he had a good look for three.
He did.
Maybe he saw Porter running at him.
They can't. Yeah. They sold out in terms of the closeout, and he saw it coming. So a simple shot fake. He thought he was going to free himself up. But that's where Old Dominion is better than most teams. They recover and help each other. Take a look. This is an open shot at first. But watch when the ball goes over. You see the sellout closeout. But then the recovery not only by Porter, but Amaya Caver was right there to help him.
Hollinsworth hits the first. He had a career-high 30 against North Texas and hit 14 of 14 from the free throw line in that 102-94 overtime victory.
Yeah, that was a game that I was there. I called that one, and man, was he good that night inside the arc as well as out. But he's got that pull-up jumper and kind of herky-jerky moves. He was really tough that night. Good freshman.
42-28.
2-3 zone now.
Green.
We have Brandon.
Yeah, Brandon, he was yelling for it, wasn't he?
Yep.
B.J. Stith from outside. In and out. And Colby the rebound. Stansberry calling the play from the side. We approach the two-minute mark.
Just three offensive rebounds for Old Dominion here tonight so far.
Justin Johnson, the left hand, and in. He's got 17.
That cross screen was enough to free him up. He caught it in close, and if he catches it in that close, he's really difficult to stop.
Green outside, and Johnson the rebound.
And we're going to see more of that 2-3 zone as long as they attack it that way. They have to find a way to penetrate it.
Bearden had a great spin move there, looking inside to Colby, and knocked away by Old Dominion.
Take a look, the ball screen, and then Johnson got freed up with a baseline screen, and once he gets it there, it's cash money.
How much value is that you can use that left hand? I mean,
Oh, yeah. His ambidexterity around the bucket is what makes him special, because his body is so big and strong and he moves well. Then he can finish with both hands. That's just very difficult to stop.
Cross-court pass, Thompson with the ball fake. Johnson. Hollinsworth with 8 on the shot clock. Colby, 3. Not exactly the shot you want.
You said that like it was a question mark. 3?
Yeah.
You know that was the first one that he's taken as a Western Kentucky Hilltopper, so with good reason you had a question mark.
Haynes misses. Only one turnover so far for Western Kentucky in this game.
They've been efficient. We talked about it. We showed it graphically, but it's borne out on the scoreboard. 44 first half points with another possession to come. And Coach Rick Stansberry has to be very impressed with this team.
Well, the last four games, Western Kentucky averaging 90 points a game. And how about this longest active road win streak in the nation?
That's in danger. But Old Dominion has not lost a game in conference on the road.
Right.
7-0, I believe.
Yes.
And now tonight, that's very much in jeopardy as Western Kentucky on their floor is pretty darn good this one up. We'll be right back.
Western Kentucky and Old Dominion currently tied for second place behind Middle Tennessee in the Conference USA standings.
And Middle's got a tough rivalry game with their travel partner, UAB, in Murfreesboro, I believe, as we speak.
Bearden down the lane. Oh, what a move! That's a couple we've seen from Lamonte Bearden.
And Lamonte Bearden is paying dividends playing that point guard. And right now, when he gets to the rim, he's got an array of moves, doesn't he?
Bearden has got some moves, and he's got some shoes, too,
man,
I'm telling you.
It may be the shoes. It must be the shoes.
Great defense by Western
it
Kentucky.
Really,
Haynes in the lane over Colby and in.
Great defense, better offense. Haynes with the spin cycle right there. Again, no matchups in transition.
Going to be Western Kentucky basketball with 5.7 on the clock. 46-30, 16-point Hilltopper lead.
Western's already used their use it or lose it, so you won't see a timeout here. But they're going to run out of bounds underneath their best play. Look for a lob at the rim with Colby or Johnson.
Johnson knocked away.
How about that?
Oh, oh man. It came so close.
That would have changed things a bit.
And a little conversation between Johnson and the official about, was that a foul? I think it was a foul. And now Johnson's going to come over and talk to the other fish.
It's a lot of discussion for a team that's up by 16 at halftime, I tell you that much.
Well, he's got 17.
Wow.
And we're at halftime. Well, a proposal, senior night, and what a first half for Justin Johnson. 17 points to lead the way as Western Kentucky has a 16-point halftime lead.
Hey everyone, Maddie Morris here inside the CUSA studio. For the Men's Basketball Weekly Awards, it's a pair of repeat winners as Marshall's CJ Burks is the Player of the Week and UTSA's Javon Jackson is the Freshman of the Week. Marshall's CJ Burks wins the Player of the Week award for the second time this season after playing a huge role in the Thundering Herd's two wins over Rice and North Texas this weekend. The junior guard averaged 31 points, 4.5 rebounds, and 2.5 assists in the two victories and was hot all weekend long, making 75% of his shots from the field, 80% of his shots from downtown, and a perfect 100% from the charity stripe. He started the weekend off scoring a career-high 36 points and grabbing a career-high 8 rebounds against the Owls, then followed that up with a game-high 26 points, including the game winner over the Mean Green. Burks is the second leading scorer for Marshall, as well as most All-CUSA players, averaging 21.4 points a game. Continuing to build his case for the Freshman of the Year honor, Javon Jackson from UTSA is once again the Freshman of the Week, winning the award for the seventh time this season. Leading the Roadrunners in points, field goals, and three-pointers this weekend, the freshman guard averaged 26 points, 2 rebounds, and 1.5 steals on the road against Old Dominion and Charlotte. He opened the weekend with a team-high 22 points against the Monarchs on Thursday, followed by a game-high 30 points versus the 49ers on Saturday. Jackson has now become the UTSA all-time leading freshman scorer and the first player in program history to eclipse the 500-point mark during his rookie season. Additionally, averaging 19.2 points a game, he ranks as the fifth leading freshman scorer in the nation, as well as the fifth leading scorer in CUSA. After leading the 49ers to two crucial road wins over Louisiana Tech and UAB this weekend, Charlotte sweeps the Women's Weekly Awards. Nyla Jamison Myers wins her first Player of the Week award of the season after averaging 16.5 points, 9 rebounds, and 5.5 blocks this past weekend. First on Thursday against Louisiana Tech, the senior forward posted her third double-double of the season, scoring 13 points while grabbing a game-high tying 11 boards. She then continued her dominant week on Saturday in Birmingham, dropping a team-best 20 points and snatching 7 rebounds in the team's 80-71 win over then-first-place UAB. A defensive powerhouse, Jamison Myers tallied 11 total blocks this weekend, including a career-best 6 in the win over Louisiana Tech, and leads the league in blocks with 60 total this season. In completing the Charlotte sweep, her teammate Octavia Wilson wins her third Freshman of the Week award of the season after posting back-to-back double-digit scoring performances. Dropping a team-high 14 points in the win over Louisiana Tech, The freshman guard shot 50% from the field and was a perfect 6 of 6 from the free throw line, while also grabbing 4 rebounds and a steal. Then on Saturday, she helped snap UAB's 7-game win streak by tallying 16 points and grabbing a pair of rebounds and a steal. In only her first year with the team, Wilson is the team's second leading scorer this season, averaging 11.3 points a contest. A big congrats to all of our Player of the Week honorees, and make sure you check out ConferenceUSA.com and follow us on our social media accounts to stay up to date on all things Conference USA basketball in the final weeks of the season.
Stadium is your new national sports network, the only 24/7 network on both television and digital devices without a cable subscription. Live and classic games, daily live studio shows, and original programming. Check your local television listings or go to watchstadium.com and click where to watch. Stadium, welcome to the game.
Welcome back here to Bowling Green, Kentucky. You like cars, Tim?
I do.
I'd love those. How about those Corvettes at the Corvette Museum?
Classic Corvettes, beautiful. Man. I would love to drive that blue one right there.
I think it would go fast. And that's how Western Kentucky has been going tonight.
Yeah,
they've
been
going fast on offense and on defense, and they lead it at halftime 46-30.
You know, I have my buddy Scott Williams, one of my old teammates, sitting here with me. He made a great observation. The first 4 minutes, Old Dominion was down 16 points. Since then, they've played even, but that punch in the mouth in the beginning is the difference in this game. And you knew Western was going to come out with a lot of energy. You knew with senior night, and they're really tough at home. They have a sellout crowd. But Old Dominion didn't seem to be ready for how big of a punch it was going to be.
Well, they didn't seem to be ready for Justin Johnson,
yeah,
who proposed to his girlfriend, and she said yes. And he scored 17 in the first half with 5 rebounds and hit his first 4 shots.
Justin was like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer when Clarice gives him a kiss and says he's cute. And he's jumping and floating. Justin was like that whole first half. And if he can live off of that euphoria for the rest of his life, he's going to have a very good marriage.
He is. No question about it. 46-30 at halftime. Western Kentucky with a 46-30 lead over Old Dominion here at halftime. Along with Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Twaddle. That was an entertaining first half if you're a Western Kentucky fan.
Particularly if you're a Justin Johnson fan, though,
Johnson.
Because that display in the first 5 minutes, really the first 10 minutes of that half, was ridiculous. But it started right here with the proposal before the game, and he kind of catapulted from that right into the game. The euphoria he was feeling there because he said yes. That allowed him to light it up once the game started. And then he got it going. You know, I checked Santa's list, and this kid is nice. 17 points, 6 of 8 from the field, 5 rebounds. He said, hey, I'm Lionel Richie. I can do this all night long. And he has been. He has been dynamite at that end. And if he continues at that pace, there's no match. Jeff Jones is going to be leaving here with the L.
Western Kentucky shooting 56% in the first half, and they only turned it over one time.
Wow, efficiency. We talked about that. We showed it graphically, and it has continued here. And they're doing it against maybe the best defensive team in the conference. Just a terrific performance for Rick Stansbury's team in the first half. Can they replicate it? We'll find out.
Their biggest lead has been 20. Right now it's 16. We'll be back in a second. Getting set for the second half here in Bowling Green, Kentucky. The Hilltoppers with a 46-30 lead over the Monarchs of Old Dominion. And you know, another week of the regular season. And then it's off to the Ford Center at the Star in Frisco, Texas for the Conference USA Tournament, March 7th and 10th. I know, Tim, you'll be there and look forward to seeing that terrific new venue. It'll be very exciting.
I'm planning on staying the whole week, even though I'm only working the first couple of rounds. But it is an exciting tournament. The people in Texas need to realize that there's some really good mid-major teams coming down there. Hopefully they'll come out and watch Middle Tennessee, Old Dominion, Western, and Marshall in particular, those top four. But watch out for the middle of the pack. UTSA is vastly improved. UAB is getting boat raced right now down in Murfreesboro. But they're a team that potentially can be reckoned with as well.
And North Texas has played some very good basketball here.
Yep, you're very right.
Caver, the lob into Porter, wow, and he loses it. All right, I was just going to ask you now, what does Old Dominion have to do here in the second half?
The first thing they have to do is try to get stops. And, you know, everyone looks at the offensive end, but comebacks are made at the defensive end. Slow down the downhill roll of Western and then try to get some easy buckets. Everything they've scored has been difficult, and you can't manufacture a comeback with all difficult shots.
Both teams turn it over in the first possession as Johnson was trying to find Colby inside.
Colby got pushed in the back right there. A little help.
Just a little bit.
From his buddy, Brandon Stiff. It's funny when you get away with stuff like that, isn't it?
It's nice to get away with stuff every once in a while, right?
Once in a while.
Caver, guarded by the freshman. Hollingsworth has done a terrific job. Haynes, he's a dangerous three-point shooter. And Johnson with a great defensive play right there.
Terrific, but the pass wasn't there.
Oh, and Johnson with the finish.
But that pass was on the money. Stiff had Johnson. If you throw something on that thing, Johnson can't get around. You got to put some heat on it.
Going inside to Brandon Stiff. Jump hook and right there. That's a terrific matchup between Johnson and Brandon Stiff.
Yeah, I love that one, and I love Porter and Colby. I mean, kind of identical skill sets for both teams at the four and the five. And Johnson's a little better perimeter shooter than Brandon Stiff, but the same body type.
Johnson for three, can't get it to go, and good. B.J. Stiff with the rebound.
Good contest by Trey Porter, though.
Porter with Johnson on him. He's going to go to work. And maybe a little push there. But
maybe. Not a foul, though.
Not a foul.
Trey Porter has to recognize whether they're doubling him or not. That was a token double. He recognized it, but he couldn't convert.
Bearden, 8 points and three assists so far on the night. He's done a terrific job. Loses it in the lane. To Colby for the slam.
That's a little offense by accident right there. A little courtesy flush, if you will.
50, 32, 18-point lead. Porter, now inside to Brandon Stiff, the jump hook. Can't get it to go, and Colby rips it out of the air. Here comes Bearden. Hollingsworth in the corner, that's a three. Caver the rebound.
The lid was ready to blow off of this building if he would have got that one to go.
Caver off the window. What a shot.
Caver is just a terrific player, plain and simple. And he makes the impossible look easy the offensive end.
He's got 12. That was a thing of beauty right there.
It really was. The hanging and the bump. He tried to get to the rim. They wouldn't let him, but the resistance didn't matter. A little smooch off the glass.
Hollingsworth, the runner, and in.
Payback, right?
Yeah.
Almost identical shot from the freshman Hollingsworth.
52-34. Haynes going inside.
They're going to call a foul,
no? Western Kentucky basketball.
Well, to me, Justin Johnson clearly lost that ball out of bounds, but I felt like he was bumped. But rather than call a foul, the officials just reward them with possession.
Xavier Green will check into the game now.
See if we can take a look.
6'6" freshman.
And Johnson's the last person. And he touched it with his other offhand as well. But he was clearly bumped in the back, so they just give him possession.
Brandon Stith will take a seat.
1-3-1. Again, they need to try to find deflections.
They're going to put Green out on Bearden right now.
And now they showed the 1-3-1, but it's actually a man-to-man.
Hollingsworth pulls up. Colby, the offensive rebound.
And that's a great job by Jeff Jones to try to disrupt this offense.
Thompson dishes to Hollingsworth, and he's fouled. You know, Thompson has only got 2 points, but he has really done a nice job taking care of a lot of the little things tonight.
He's a fifth-year senior, played in the ACC. He understands how to play basketball, but more importantly, understands how to impact the game without scoring.
55-34, that's the biggest lead of the night at 21 for Western Kentucky as we approach the 16-minute mark.
Jeff Jones's team, Old Dominion, needed to do what Western has done. Outscore him in the first 5 minutes.
Taver has it blocked by Colby. And it's going to go over to Western Kentucky. So Colby with his 55th block of the year.
Give Rick Stansberry's team a lot of credit because they've been locked in defensively. There hasn't been, I don't remember any easy shots Old Dominion has hit tonight.
Justin Johnson got stuck as he tried the fall away, and he got doubled by Porter there. B.J. Stith can't get it to go, and Colby the rebound.
Every shot, that looked like a short layup, and it was contested.
Hollinsworth,
beautiful.
He lost the ball, was able to regroup and finish. And now Western Kentucky leads it by 23. Welcome back here to Western Kentucky, where the Hilltoppers have a 57-34 lead over the Monarchs of Old Dominion. 15:36 left to go in the game, and that man Justin Johnson with 19 points on the evening, and he has put on quite a show. 7 rebounds, and this 23-point lead, the largest lead of the night.
He's got an opportunity, as we talked about, to get to 1,000 rebounds in his career.
Guarding B.J. Stith over there. Caver now gets inside. Wow, high off the glass.
Wow.
Not able to complete it. He's down as he ran into Colby. Blocked at the other end, and it's going to go over to Old Dominion.
Things just aren't going well for Old Dominion right now. That was a short two. The Porter couldn't clean it.
Point Western Kentucky lead over Old Dominion. And another game taking place tonight, Middle Tennessee and UAB at the Murphy Center in Murfreesboro. Middle Tennessee ranked 24th.
And I think they're better than that. And right now, Nick King, in my opinion, player of the year in Conference USA, is getting it done with 13. Giddy Potts, giddy up with 14. And you know, when those two get it going, and it's not just them, they just have so many weapons. Kermit Davis does a great job with that group.
We'll be down there to see them against Marshall next Saturday, which should be a very entertaining game. But the pressure continues, Tim, by Western Kentucky.
Marshall's the only team to beat Middle Tennessee here in this season in Conference USA.
Godwin has checked into the game, number 0 for Old Dominion.
Nice
and
move.
Yeah, nice move right there by Porter.
And you know, if Western hangs on to this lead here and wins this game, they'll be 14-2, setting up a showdown at Middle Tennessee on Thursday night.
Bearden trying to take it down the baseline, knocked out of bounds. It'll remain with Western Kentucky. So it looks like Jeff Jones has gone to more size. He's put Green in there. He's got Godwin in there.
Size on the perimeter.
Yes.
Trying to do something to disrupt these guards. They have been killing them.
Oh, what a pass by Thompson to Colby.
Man, they could not handle that pick and roll very well at all. No one at the bucket. No.
There was a lot of traffic in there. I don't know how he found it, but he did.
Nice pocket pass. And now 2-3.
Battle underneath. Porter, Johnson, Colby. It's a scrum.
And we have to wait and see if he got enough for the first down. Depends on the spot. But take a look at the play right before. And there's a decision that Green's got to make. And he was trying to cheat out to his teammate, to the guy he's guarding on the perimeter. But he forgot about the bucket, the back door wide open.
7 assists now for Thompson. Just 2 points, but 7 assists.
He doesn't need a scorer. But he is a good scorer. That's the thing about and what makes Western very tough. And if they hold on tonight, I can't wait for Thursday night. We're not covering that game, but, boy, I'll be watching.
Porter had to leave the game. They're checking out his right thumb. Bearden. Nice there. Thompson was inside. The ball's knocked around. It's going to go to Old Dominion. Good look there by Bearden.
There's been some resistance at the bucket at both ends. There's a couple times it looks like a short putback by Porter and Brandon Stiff, and somehow they come up empty because of the long arms of Colby and Johnson.
That's Godwin. Number zero is a freshman from Hampton, Virginia. Green tried to hang in the air, gets his miss back. Goes to B.J. Stiff. In and out won't go, and Hollingsworth comes away with it.
First clean look of the second half right there for Old Dominion. Couldn't cash it in.
Bearden. Oh. Hammer.
No one said Old Dominion doesn't play physical. Let's see if we can take a look at the other end, though. A nice, quick sideline break. They have not had the sideline covered in transition, and it's been really a real breakdown, and Western has taken advantage with that sideline break. They've gotten opportunities at the basket as a result.
But Bearden misses the first one as Haynes checks back into the game, and Green will sit down. Foul was on Brandon Stiff.
Western makes a living at the free throw line. They haven't really just 13 free throws now tonight.
That's an upset. But he missed them both, and he's their best free throw shooter at 83%.
Well, they have a lot of good ones, though. Yeah. They make more free throws than their opponents have taken this season.
Brandon Stiff blocked by Colby. Give me that. Here comes Hollingsworth. Hollingsworth gets his miss back. Loose ball. Thompson puts it up and draws the foul.
There's a few fouls in there, I think. A lot of hands. But again, resistance at the bucket. Go up and let me take that from you from both sides. Johnson and Colby, we just talked about how they're protecting the rim. Not today.
Darius Thompson will head to the free throw line.
Thompson, the leading scorer on this team by a percentage point. He and Justin Johnson around 15 a game.
The officials are going over to the monitor.
And this is routine for NCAA basketball. Anytime there's contact above the neck in any situation, and it doesn't have to be on the prior play. It could be 5, 10, 15 plays ago. If they think that occurred, they're going to go and take a look at it.
We mentioned the first meeting this year, as we take a look now at Hollingsworth.
Good defense there without fouling. Hollingsworth was forced to pump it a couple times, couldn't convert. Now right here is where things start to get a little ugly in terms of reaching. Let's see if Hollingsworth kept that pivot foot too. He did a great job. And so far, I don't see anything that warrants any kind of flagrant play.
Brandon Stiff kind of lost his balance, and it looked like he fell into him.
Yeah, that's no crime, though, but let's see.
Coming in from behind.
Yeah,
you see,
I see that.
It might have caught him in the head right there.
If anything, Brandon Stiff got hit in the above the neck and shoulder, but he fell into a guy, so you can't penalize them for that.
So Thompson will go to the line, 72% free throw shooter, and he has been to the free throw line more than any other Western Kentucky player. As Aaron Carver checks into the game for Old Dominion.
And the grad transfers, Thompson and Colby, have really changed the complexion of this team.
Well, it's amazing. Just one returning player from last year, Justin Johnson. And you know, freshmen have really stepped up.
True.
Hollingsworth, obviously. And then
Anderson.
Nelson and Omer. 61-36. Biggest lead of the game now for Western Kentucky.
This 2-3 zone has bothered
going
them.
For the lob and the foul.
Goodness.
Justin Johnson thought he got all ball. We'll go to the replay, but he was called for the foul.
You know, I have never seen an alley-oop lob contested like this before. At any level. level. It's usually the guy he's not ready for. But that is as clean as it gets right there.
Man.
The crowd, they're a little partial, I will say.
Yes.
But I believe they're right tonight.
Brandon Stipp.
Wow.
Gets a free throw.
We talked about offering resistance. Look at that. Meet me at the top floor.
I mean, you're talking about getting up high. Both of those guys.
So clean, though.
This is the second one.
We saw the back screen being set. Johnson recognized it and got to where the ball was. That was a great defensive play.
Just the first foul on Johnson. Thompson, bounce pass inside. Ball comes loose and Haynes will take it down court. Anderson in there now for Western Kentucky. And count it.
Nasty
spill. Foul's going to be on Colby as B.J. Stiff.
But you got to be impressed again with the ability to get back in transition and recover off that turnover. They made it tough. Another tough shot being taken. Even when you think this should be an easy one, Western Kentucky has been tough.
Now, this has been a physical game, and there haven't been that many fouls called.
I like it, though.
The Old Dominion's only been free throw line three times going to this moment. And Western Kentucky has had 15 trips to the line as Colby will sit down and Nelson comes in.
And I'm sure Jeff Jones doesn't like that inequity, but that's the reality he's dealing with right now. And it's not like Old Dominion hasn't taken it to the basket, because they have. It's been a lot of clean plays, in my opinion, protecting that rim from Western.
Well, good job right there by Johnson. He tip it back, and Anderson was able to come up with it.
Now they're going small, Western. Kind of small, because they have some really big guards in there with Nelson and Darius Thompson. But no one over 6'7" on the floor.
That's Nelson. Bounce pass into Johnson. The jump hook won't go. Anderson, the offensive board in.
Anderson. He just wanted it more than the boys in blue.
63-39.
Staying in the 2-3. It's been effective here in the second half for Western.
Miss and the rebound by Johnson.
This is an Old Dominion team. You think about it, they've been scoring a lot of points lately. 82, 100, 82, 84. Not tonight.
Nelson, and another assist for guess who? Darius Thompson.
And that was a UCLA cut off the high screen on the post, and Old Dominion didn't guard it well.
Inside, and Haynes able to convert. 65-41 as we approach the 10:30 mark left to go here at Western Kentucky. We've got a whistle, fouls on B.J. Stiff, and we've got a timeout on the floor.
There's been a lot of resistance at the rim. That one was a foul, but I say it was not. Good play, Johnson.
24-point lead for Western Kentucky as they've done it on the glass tonight, too. 31-23 in the rebounding category. And, Tim, the resume watch with these two teams at records of 22-5 for Old Dominion, 21-7 for Western Kentucky.
And in my opinion, especially if Western wins tonight, they have the better of those two resumes, even though they only have really one quality win over Purdue. But you look at the bad losses, UTSA and Ohio for Old Dominion. But really, the only team that's probably going to be considered for an at-large bid in this conference is Middle Tennessee. And I think they've already made their case, quite honestly.
Oh, no question.
They should be in the tournament no matter what happens.
Eight on the shot clock. Hollinsworth. Darius Thompson, the runner. And the follow and in! Thompson!
He passed that to himself.
Miss. Yeah. They say the clock expired?
I think so. And I did hear the buzzer. His first shot definitely did not hit the rim, but I think they're going to go look at it and find out. Let's see. We'll make the call here. Thompson, two on the shot clock. Yeah, there's no way he got that. Oh, I don't know. Very close. I'm gonna say the old French monarch, Count the Bucket. Still no explanation.
Yeah,
from
it's
the
good.
Official.
Oh, they're gonna say it's good. Okay. 67-41.
Yeah, hey, Count the Bucket.
You were right on top of that.
It's a good job to look at it, though. It was very close.
Godwin, the air ball.
But a tough night for that coach right there, Jeff Jones. And his team has been playing so well. Again, we talked about the six straight wins and seven straight road wins in conference in jeopardy right now.
67-41 with 9:50 left to go. Anderson and in. That was pretty easy right there.
Too easy. Right down Broad Street. Philadelphia reference.
There you go.
Right there.
I know. I know you get a Philly reference in every game.
Got to.
I understand that.
Got to.
Stiff.
Nice.
Brandon Stiff.
That was as good as they've attacked that 2-3 zone. That was the best possession so far here in the second half.
And so, folks, this is a really good defensive team, Old Dominion. Yeah. I mean, it's a really good. What are they giving up? 62 points a game?
62.3, yeah.
And
which is hard to
Western
do.
Kentucky's got 69 with over 9 minutes left to go.
Think about this. They gave up 33 points last Saturday to UTEP for the game.
Three on the shot clock. Hollingsworth in the lane. The runner. And in. That's the way to work the clock.
Serendipitous. Everything going right for Western.
Colby and Omer will check in for Western Kentucky. Justin Johnson. There's what we're talking about. That's fourth in the nation.
Fourth in the nation.
Field goal percentage.
Yeah, and that's 62.6 and 41% field goal, 36. But tonight, a different story. 71 points, 56% shooting. Western continues the hot streak in terms of how they're playing on offense over the last several games now.
Something about those schools in Virginia that can play defense.
That sure is.
As Caver knocks down the three, and he has been their source of offense. He's got 15 points to lead the way for the Monarchs this evening.
If you're struggling offensively, you don't want to go to Norfolk or Charlottesville in Virginia. Not going to get well.
Well, Western Kentucky, very contentious to use clock here now.
Let's see if they can start getting good shots late in possessions.
Five on the shot clock. The Colby can't get the flush.
Great assignment, though.
Yep.
Green was right there. Nice pass.
Good look. Brandon Stith from the pass from Caver.
A rare breakdown in transition, though. We haven't seen that. Western has not had a lot of breakdowns defensively. They have been tight.
71-48. Nelson, Anderson, and Omer, all true freshmen. Going for Nelson on the lob, can't finish it. And here comes Caver. Pull up won't go, and Nelson with the rebound, and he's fouled from behind. We get a timeout, 7:36 left to go. It's all Western Kentucky. '71-48, 7:36 left to go here. Western Kentucky with a huge lead. I want to remind you, next Saturday, coming your way, Tim and I will be down in Murfreesboro for Marshall and Middle Tennessee. That's next Saturday at 7 Eastern time. Hope you'll join us for that one.
Could be a really important game when you think about it. Middle could be trying to wrap up the conference championship. Marshall trying to hang on to that fourth spot, which would give them a first round bye
right.
in Conference
huge.
USA tournament.
That's huge because last year Marshall had to play four, got to the final game. I don't know how you can do that. I mean, quite frankly,
that's hard to do four games in four nights. Yeah. And to me, they ran out of gas in that championship game. versus Middle Tennessee. But a great job by D'Antoni's team all year this season.
Well, Colby and Porter got connected. They're going to call the foul on Colby.
Very nicely put.
Yeah.
Still a lot of time in this game, enough to make a comeback, but I just don't see any easy buckets being scored by Old Dominion.
Haynes for three, hits it. Now, are you thinking there was a Drexel had a 34-point comeback against Delaware the other day?
Yes, that was unbelievable.
But that was a little bit longer. That
certainly,
was a little, yeah.
Right. Certainly a statistical anomaly, yeah. Too. You just don't see teams be that good to be up 34 points and then be that bad to lose it.
Anderson lost it, but they're going to call the foul. It's on Xavier Green.
Think about how many 34-point leads we've seen in college basketball. Not many. But that is a huge basketball lead. And to blow it is just incredible.
Old Dominion's been on an 8-0 run, and so the lead right now is 20 with 6:53 to go, and that'll get Justin Johnson and Lonte Bearden back into the game. So Anderson, 6'6 freshman from Baton Rouge, heads to the free throw line and knocks down the first one. You know, it was interesting talking to Rick Stansbury when he first became eligible. He said, I'm not worried about this young man at all because, one, he is a terrific defensive player. So
yeah.
I can play him right away and not, and you know, you're a coach. You got to play defense before you can play offense, right?
You do.
Yeah.
You know, coaches love to talk about defense, but man, they love when you can put that ball in the basket. But he can do that. But the thing that makes him good, as long as he's not turning it over and in here throwing it around, he plays within himself. Again, I think he's going to be a special player before it's all said and done here in Bowling Green.
73-51. Caver. Haynes going inside. Turnaround shot. Colby!
Fouled him.
Boy, it looked like that was a pretty good block right there. As Trey Porter trying to hit the turnaround shot.
Old Dominion is known for their defense, but I've been really impressed with the defense in Western Kentucky today.
And misses that first one. Old Dominion leads the all-time series against Western Kentucky 18-17 and have won six of the last seven. As Porter connects on that one.
Old Dominion has been able to handle everybody in the conference, but their two losses so far have been to Middle and to Western. And if they lose again tonight, they will have gotten swept.
And
by
both
Western.
Of those at home.
Yeah, both of those were home games. So any tiebreakers that Old Dominion would be in, they would probably lose with those two.
Western taking their time. Thompson. Got it. Wow, there's a veteran player right there, huh? That's the epitome of him. He wasn't rushed. He was not in a hurry. He was confident. When they gave him a shot, he took it and made it.
And you're looking at the leading scorer on this team, and he hasn't been hunting shots.
Green misses. Johnson skies, and it's off stiff. So it will be Western Kentucky basketball with a 23-point lead and 5:51 left to go.
Frustrating evening for Old Dominion. Stiff in particular. He has not had the impact on the glass that he had the night on Thursday versus Marshall.
Thompson going inside. Ball is knocked loose and a player down on the floor and they're going to stop playing. And Rick Stansbury doesn't like that, but down on the floor there's Xavier Green.
Yeah.
Took a hard fall. I think that's the right thing to do.
But here's the reason why. Because of where he was located, he was right under the rim,
right.
And he had three guys coming there, going right to the rim. Somebody was surely going to land on him. But he took food off the table for Western.
I get it, but the official waited, in my opinion, too long. I mean, he went down on the play. The ball got down towards the other end, and then as Western was starting to come down to that end, is when they blew. See, now he's watching this. He's down. You can tell.
And that's fine. That's the discretion of the official.
Right.
He can let them play on. But once they perceive a dangerous situation, which clearly that would have been.
Right.
You got three guys going to the rim with a guy laying underneath the ground. That's a dangerous play for the Western players.
Right, and the right call was eventually made.
Yes.
I think it could have just been called a little sooner, myself. Because he wasn't moving.
I think there are 9,000 people in here that agree with you. He had basically a chalk outline around his body. He was down there so long.
On the baseline, Justin Johnson is fouled by Trey Porter. So after an amazing first half, Justin Johnson, things have cooled off offensively for him.
A little bit, but they haven't needed him. Solid performance, though. 19 points, 10 rebounds. Just one personal foul. Doesn't have an assist yet, though.
And misses that free throw.
Unless you want to count the ring he dished out before the game. You count that as an assist?
Yes.
Maybe the best one of the night,
yes.
Right?
5:10 left to go in this game. Haynes goes inside to Porter. Jump hook.
That's nice.
Yeah. That's hard to stop right there.
It is, because he elevates so high and he's so long.
Porter with 6 points, averages over 12 a game. Got in foul trouble against Marshall the other night and was very effective for him later in the game. I mean, they really depended on him. Western content to get that shot clock down below 10. Hollingsworth, and in! Oh, what a move! He went over Porter that time.
He is a terrific freshman. I'm telling you, we talked about Anderson. Hollingsworth is already one of the better players in this league.
DJ Smith hits the three and then a whistle underneath.
They're going to possibly get a 4-point play. Smith knocks down the three, and Trey Porter got knocked down as well. He'll go to the line. And a disqualification, right?
His fifth foul.
He gets a rousing ovation, well deserved. 11 points, 8 rebounds, and 30 minutes of play.
He gets a standing ovation from the crowd here at Diddle Arena.
They're not in the bonus, so I believe Old Dominion is just going to get a possession. So a chance for a 6-point play. Senior night applause right there.
20-point lead for Western Kentucky with 4:20 left to go.
Last time we'll see Dwight Colby in a Western Kentucky uniform.
Block
in this building.
Anderson with the block. Hollingsworth. And in. He hits the deck again. No call. 79-57.
Hollingsworth is having fun, man. I tell you.
And Brandon Stitt with the basket. 20-point lead for Western Kentucky. Oh, the slam doesn't go for Anderson. No call there. Stith, the turnaround shot. Won't go. Porter, the offensive board, and slams it home. Might have been a step. Might have been a step.
He took that extra one to gather himself, but man, did he get up on that rim.
18-point game as we approach the 3-minute mark. And Rick Stansbury says, just spread it out.
Well played, well coached game for the Hilltoppers.
Hollingsworth with 13 of his 18 in the second half. Bearden, I don't know where he was going with that one.
Watch out.
And Brandon Smith has it stripped away by Josh Anderson.
That was about to be a Showtime dunk. Turns into a turnover. Great defensive play.
Oh, that was terrific. And that gets a standing ovation. In the lane, and in. What'd you call that move?
They call it a Euro.
He just went over 1,000 career points with that basket.
And he's telling them what he did.
Oh, how about these guys?
Oh, man, they are having fun.
81-61. And the block by Anderson. And Hollingsworth, the finish. Welcome back. Along with Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Schwabel. Great to be with you on senior night here at Western Kentucky, where the Hilltoppers have a 20-point lead and 2:11 left to go. The officials have been taking a look at this.
What they're trying to look at is three-pointer. Yeah,
plenty of room, right?
And, man, that would have been an NBA three, I think. That was deep.
20-point lead for Western. Hewitt in now, number 11, as Jeff Jones has gone to the bench.
Steven Vassar, 23, into the game as well.
That's Green, and he hits it. 81-63, so 1:40 remaining, and the crowd starting to stand here at Diddle Arena. Thompson will take the three, hits it! Oh, man!
They're probably going to get Thompson and Johnson there standing ovation one at a time.
And 84 points, the most Old Dominion has given up this year.
Remarkable. What a performance. I think they're going to get both those seniors out of the game right now. Take a look at where Darius Thompson shoots that one. From Charlottesville, Virginia, where he transferred. Justin Johnson, again, if you take another look, Johnson kisses the floor as he goes out of the game. His final Western Kentucky performance on this floor.
Johnson, 19 points and 11 rebounds, and he got them off to the great start tonight. Vassar the rebound, and he throws it away. Josh Anderson, look out here, folks. Oh, my goodness. That's a senior night special right there by the freshman.
Wow.
One minute to play.
That was for the seniors. Trying to throw the lob. Bearden down court to Hollingsworth. I think they're fired up here tonight, Tim.
And they should be, because
my goodness,
this has been quite a dismantling of a very good team. Remember, both these teams are 13-2 in conference. Take a look at Justin Johnson's reaction. So is that cheating? Because he kissed somebody else.
How about this?
And the run out by Anderson. Beautiful. And the bench loves it.
Yeah, Omer had to leave the game. He got he caught one in the mouth, and so they had to.
Yeah, and then we see.
Get the blood cleaned up off the floor.
That's not red paint, right? That's a little CSI Bowling Green action right here. Forensics experts come through. And there's more.
There's always
he left
more.
The trail.
There's always more.
There's always more. There's a lot more.
Yeah,
he was ready to leave. Here we go.
There
come
we go.
On. Right. Some more. Wow, look at the blood on him. That was quite a collision. I saw it when he did. He reached in trying to get a loose ball. And I wonder if he's got all his teeth.
All right. night. Here's senior night. Darius Thompson. How about that line? 11 points, 8 assists, 6 rebounds. Justin Johnson, 19 points, 11 boards. And Dwight Colby, 11 and 8. So
Darius Thompson is flirting again with the triple-double.
Yes, he is.
He's got one.
Godwin for three. Hits it.
And if you're Western Kentucky, you got to be careful. You may see this team again in the semifinals in 2 weeks in Texas. You don't want to show them up. You better be respectful because they are, quite frankly, not 22 points better than Old Dominion. They just played a very good game, and Old Dominion didn't play very well tonight.
Well, there was so much emotion by Western Kentucky on senior night, and Johnson got them started. Their defensive intensity never stopped.
Exactly right. They played off that energy.
John with a miss.
These 9,000 people will not be in Frisco, Texas to help them.
That'll do it. Western Kentucky with an 88-66 victory over Old Dominion. Folks, the party started early tonight, and it just continued as this Western Kentucky team, led by as many as 26, never really in doubt. Old Dominion, right from the get-go, just was taken out of the game by this Western Kentucky team and this great crowd here tonight. So for Tim Scarborough, I'm Roger Twidell. Final score, Western Kentucky 88, Old Dominion 66. We're going to join College Basketball Spotlight in progress with LaSalle and Buck.